In the previous video, we saw an introduction to Helm and got an understanding of its structure. We learned that a central concept in Helm is a Go-based template that combines with a configuration file to form the Kubernetes deployment manifest. In this video, let's dig a bit deeper into the specifics of templates. We will learn enough about templates to write our first chart. Templates are applied on a data structure. The annotations used in a template contain elements of that data structure. The current position in the data structure is represented by a dot. The actions in a template, which could be control structures or elements of a data structure, are specified between two opening and closing curly braces. Everything outside the curly braces is copied as it is. To demonstrate templates, let's create a trivial namespace manifest to create a namespace in Kubernetes. We begin by creating the root directory for the char called Helm Template Demo. The first file we create is char.yml, which only contains the name and version. The second file we create is values.yml. This is the data structure that we will use in the template. The root element is company, and it has two elements, team and env. Next, we create the templates directory with a single template called namespace.yml. We write that file by specifying the version and kind as namespace. And in the metadata, we template the name by using the env from values.yml file. The data structure in the braces begin with dot, which is a root, followed by values object, which contains everything inside values.yml. We can then traverse the values object to get the env. Besides values, there are other objects available in the template, such as release, which describes the release and has a name, time, namespace, and so on. Chart, that contains the values from chart.yml. Files, this gives us access to all other files that are not special to charts. Capabilities, information about the cluster. Template, information about the current template. Templates also provide a way to transform values using functions and pipelines. Functions in templates are again written within the curly braces, and they follow the pattern function name followed by arguments. Helm uses functions from the Go template language and also from the Sprig template library. For example, we use the length function to add an annotation to a namespace.yml. An important function is the default function. Its format is default, default value, and then the value. For example, we add another annotation called machine and get its value from the values.yml file. Since it's not present, the engine will use the default value, which in our case is HP. The pipe symbol that you see is a pipeline. Pipelines allow chaining of commands using a pipe. The output of the first command is added as the last argument to the next command. For example, we create a string joining the name of the env with length of teammate using a pipe. Let's use the tree command to see how our chart directory structure looks like. To see how the resulting template looks without executing it, we use the dry run combined with the debug argument. We see that the env has been correctly injected into the manifest. Templates also allow certain actions in control structures such as if-else. This says that if value in pipeline is empty, execute T0, else execute T1. We will not go through all the actions in this video. One important construct that you will see is the open curly braces, followed by a dash and a space. This tells the engine to trim all white spaces preceding the open brace. Similarly, a white space followed by a dash and closing curly braces tells the engine to ignore all white spaces after the closing brace. Templates also have variables that allow assigning the value to a variable. For example, release name equals release.name. This assigns the value of release name to the name of the release. It is also possible to use nested templates, that is, create a template block and use it within another template. To create a name template block, use the define action. Name templates are generally created in a file called _helpers.tpl. We will use a name template in the next video when we deploy our Spring Boot application. In this video, we took a whirlwind tour into writing templates. We We have deliberately not covered all the actions and functions since the purpose of the video is only to show you how to use them and not to explain them all. We recommend two web pages mentioned in this slide for a more exhaustive list. In the next video, we will use templates to deploy our Spring RESTful API. So stay tuned!